If you understand these basic truths, and if you bring these basic truths as your conscious conclusion, it infuses superpowers in you. See, listen. When you are lusty, everything looks romantic. Purpose of the flower changes. Purpose of your identity looks different. Purpose of your life becomes different. When you are terrorized, frightened, in fear, even your cognition gets so deluded. You see only in life negative things inside you, outside you, all around you. You actually not just look silly, you become silly when you are terrorized, when you are frightened, when you are shaken. I tell you, come to the conscious conclusion, neither fear nor greed, neither honey mood nor bullying mood. When you are terrorized, you try to bully others. Neither honey mood nor bullying mood should be your core existence. Don't make decisions in honey mood or bullying mood. Make decisions in nandi mood. Don't make decisions in bullying mood. When you are terrorized, the natural reaction will be bullying. You will bully yourself or you will bully others. When you bully yourself, you collapse you. When you bully others, you try to collapse them. So, no bullying mood, no horny mode. When I say horny, sexual horny, H-O-R-N-Y. Neither horny mode, it's not only about sexuality. Even if you are lusty for money or some luxuries, even those modes should not be your power source. Based on that, you should not be taking decisions. Understand, listen carefully. Understand this one example, then you will understand what I am trying to convey. Once or twice, rarely, if you eat non-veg, it's not that your whole life will be destroyed. But when non-vegetarian food becomes your lifestyle, you will collapse yourself, destroy yourself irreparably. Same way, once in a while you made some decisions when you are sexually horny or you are greedy about some luxury, those one or two decisions will not destroy your whole life. Don't worry too much about that past or what you did and all that. But don't making decisions while you are horny, making decisions when you are terrorized, it's a lifestyle. That's all I am saying. When you start making decisions in Paramashanta space, you will become so productive for yourself and others. I have always seen these people who flare up. They work 10 years, 20 years and build something so hard in their life, and they just
get so deluded, they don't even know what they are destroying, and they just destroy stupidly. And then later on repent. But by the time it is too late, even if you repent, it's too late. I have seen many people who are leaving the Kailasa, leaving the Sangha. Deep delusion. Instead of breaking the delusion, they break the most valuable, precious gift given to them by Paramashiva. Life in Kailasa, life in my Sangha is the greatest gift Paramashiva can give you. And same way, I have seen that positive side when people feel the intense love, how the spiritual experience and enlightenment transformation manifests in them. Ordinarily, people need to work 12 years for one powerful cognition to manifest. But when people feel connected to me in intense love, I can see Paramashiva manifests in them just like that. Because you are breathing, my breathing, both are connected to Paramashiva.